If you like this video, please like and subscribe, and turn on those notifications. You know what it is about humans, especially men, who always think they can do better than the best athletes or professionals. We see all the evidence in their fights showing that we have no chance. But I guess it's a little like bad auditions on American Idol, where no one has told these people that they actually suck. So let's get started with this list. This first clip comes from Jackass, where we know that the guys act like idiots and the challenger is Johnny Knoxville, who decides to take on Butterbean. Butterbean was a professional 350-pound fighter with a record of 77 wins and 10 losses. I guess the Jackass guys thought that this would be a funny fight because of how big Butterbean is, but he certainly taught Johnny a lesson since he was able to knock him out.
Schlag mich mal, na los! Na geht doch!
Butterbean held nothing back and swung as hard as he could. I actually can't believe that Knoxville got up after that first knockdown. And Butterbean even let him take a free shot, but it didn't even faze him. So we all know that alcohol gives you a lot of fake bravado, and this clip is evidence of this as we have a drunk Australian challenging a professional Muay Thai fighter. Well, maybe it's more of a case of him not being sure what is happening, since we hear him asking if this is for real or fake fighting. But apparently he was the one that challenged the fighter, and somehow he forgot about it.
Wait, are we playing for real or like fake? Am I gonna get beaten the fuck up or what?
Well, you said
it's for real.
Like real money. That's what you said to him.
You tested him, man.
As soon as he throws his first weak and playful kick, he knows that it's for real, since a Muay Thai fighter comes back with a solid punch to the face. You can even see that he was a little dizzy from the punch. Then the Muay Thai fighter just chops him down and the Aussie turns his back and quits. This fight is more of a fun fight between a professional MMA fighter, Josh Kochek, and a fan. The fan challenged Josh to a fight, and at first it was supposed to be just one fight, but after losing fairly quickly with an armbar, the challenger wanted to make a best out of three. Even after having time to reassess the fight after losing the first match, the challenger is unable to block a straight head kick by Josh, and I'm surprised he didn't get knocked out. The challenger had nothing in this fight, and Josh was able to do whatever he wanted. Here we have another overconfident bodybuilder who assumes that just by having muscles, he will be able to dominate a smaller fighter. So he challenges black belt jiu-jitsu fighter and instructor Pedro Sauer to a fight. Pedro is recognized as one of the best jiu-jitsu instructors and had no problem taking care of this challenger. He starts by soundly beating the bodybuilder standing up, with distracting kicks to the legs and then good punches to the face.
Bleeding. Here, a left hook opens up a cut under Lance's right eye.
Once the challenger takes the fight to the ground, where he thinks that he will be better because of his size, Pedro is in his element and just controls the fight from there, and doesn't allow the strongman to even land a good punch.
Lance's futile blows have no effect against Pedro's maneuvers.
Go!
With the arm lock in perfect position and Lance losing his balance as he topples to the ground, he taps out on Pedro's leg. Pedro shows great mercy by releasing Lance's arm just before it reaches its breaking point.
This is Patrick Martin, and he had the bright idea to call out a professional MMA fighter in Josh Neer. Josh has had over 50 professional MMA fights, and he has won 36 of them, so this guy is a legit fighter. Even knowing this, Patrick decides to taunt him in these texts, and well, he really got under Neer's skin, since he got his ass whooped. Patrick is way bigger than Neer with a longer reach, but he couldn't use that to his advantage and was soon taken to the ground, where Neer just elbowed and punched him until he had to be forcefully be pulled off of him. This wealthy Chinese event promoter apparently has too much money and too much time on his hands since he challenged Bo Cao Banchmak to fight him. It is unclear how much he paid, but he challenged one of the greatest Muay Thai fighters. I have to think that in order to get to this point, you have to have done everything that money can buy, or maybe this is the only way he can get his rocks off anymore. I'm pretty sure the Chinese guy has never thrown a punch in his life, cause damn, he sucks. Bo Cao was letting him throw and land punches and wasn't really trying to hurt him. But the funniest part is the way the Chinese businessman gave up. He basically faked the knockout.
It was a knockdown.
This fight took place before Nate Diaz made his name in the UFC when he was only 17 years old. He took on the much older Robert Limon in a bare knuckle but open-handed strike fight. Limon was way too indecisive with his kicks when the fight first started and he was taken to the ground by Diaz fairly easily. Limon tried to get a guillotine in but was unable to hold it. Then Diaz got full control and quickly finished the fight with an armbar. I think that Limon's inability to adjust and think beyond the guillotine choke is what made him lose even faster. In 2006, Roy Jones Jr. decided to hold a contest on Facebook where he would fight a fan, and if they won, they would get $100,000. 1,500 people entered, and the lucky or unlucky fan was Byron Phillips. Phillips was an MMA fighter but had no training in boxing. I guess that he felt that he could use his MMA skills to beat a 47-year-old Jones, but that was not the case. He got hurt late in the first round by a right-left combination that just left Jones smiling. Then in the second round, Jones dodged the punch and countered with a thundering right hand that ended the fight.
Certainly did. Some more.
Nice hard body shot by Roy Jones. Down goes.
Man, he's done. Yeah. He's rolling on his glove. If he gets up, I'll be a big fan of his.
That's it.
It's a smart stoppage.
An actual ninja, or at least a self-proclaimed ninja, challenged Dominic Cruz to a fight back in 2008. The ninja is actually quite respectful, since ninjas are supposed to kill you without you even realizing that they are there. But he decided to come out in the open and fight one of the best MMA fighters. He obviously starts with his flashy hand movement, but as is expected, he had no takedown defense. Once on the ground, Cruz just beats him non-stop, changing to all types of control and positions, never letting him get any strikes in.
Brandon, don't coach, just so he has no coach either, please. Don't coach, he has no coach either.
They do go for a second round, and this time Cruz decides to beat him in the standing position with his very unorthodox style. Recently, Mikey Garcia was able to win 4 championships in 4 different weight divisions, joining the ranks of fighters like Manny Pacquiao, Floyd Mayweather Jr., Roy Jones Jr., and Oscar De La Hoya. But here we have a 220-pound hater challenging the 145-pound Mikey Garcia to a fight. This guy talked a lot of shit about Mikey and to Mikey Garcia himself. But he doesn't even last one round. Being the bigger man and even wearing the headgear, he still can't take Mikey's hits. I guess Mikey was throwing pretty hard, and he ended the fight with a very good 1-2 combination. According to the hater, the most surprising part of the challenge was Mikey's endurance. So thanks to your great recommendations, I was able to provide a video with higher profile fighters being challenged. We are truly able to see how big the difference is between trained fighters and random guys off the street. So here's the question, would you accept the $100,000 challenge to take on an old Roy Jones Jr.? I think I would take on the challenge, but I'm pretty sure I wouldn't get out of the first round. Thanks for watching.